I've never seen this picture before. Is this from the time you lived in Hidden Pines?
This is crazy!
Her spouse was caught next to the dead body.
This must have been taken right after we moved into the new house there. It wasn't all beer and bonbons back then, I can tell you that.
I guess you're finally old enough to hear the story from the ground up. Who would you like to start?
Wanted to get away from the stress of big city living. The decision to move to Hidden Pines was easy. It's a small town where everyone knows each other.
This is the last box. Once again, I sincerely apologize for being late.
We had just arrived and were planning our perfect life when we received an unexpected letter.
The moving company's late, and this place is a mess. I can't even find the champagne bottle.
Don't worry, honey. I'll find it. Why don't you head over to the neighbor's place? I'll be there in a sec.
All right, but I'm taking the fake mustache. Looks like you'll have to rely on your own fabulous facial hair for the party. Don't forget the champagne.
Thank you.
Move along, people. Nothing to see here. We need to clear the area.
Honey, meet me at the police station right away. I'm innocent.
I know where the police station is. It will cost you about $3 to get there. Plus a last tip.
The police station is in the town square. I'm sorry, but I have to stay here and secure the crime scene.
I just saw the sheriff take someone away. People are saying it's one of the new neighbors. Oh. Was that your spouse?
I'm really sorry to hear about your situation. People are saying there was a murder at the party. Because you're new here, I'll drive you around for free until this is cleared up. Take the town map as well. You're gonna need it. The police station is at the building on the right. I'll wait for you in the car.
I'm sorry, but only employees are allowed at the pier. During the war, every ship anchored in hidden pines. But that's another story. I'll tell you all about it when you have more time.
What can I do for you? Oh, that's your spouse. Before tonight, the worst thing this town had to deal with was the disappearance of Mrs. Robinson's cat. Now we have this. As the sheriff around these parts, I haven't seen too many murders. But your spouse was caught next to the mayor's wife's dead body. So this case seems pretty cut and dry to me. Still, there's no harm in you talking to your spouse. The cells are in the back.
Oh, thank goodness you're here. I was about to lose my mind. We don't have much time. Someone is trying to set me up. After I left the house and headed to the party...
No, bad dog. I'm so sorry. It's all my fault. He gets really anxious if there's no food in his bowl. So you're the new neighbor. I'm Mildred, the Greenwald family's housekeeper for decades. Nice to meet you. You're just in time for the party. I'll take care of this little rascal. Come on, boy. Here you go.
Welcome, neighbor. I'm William Greenwald, mayor of Hidden Pines. It's always a pleasure to meet new members of our quaint little town.
Hey, William! Elmer's here. We're all set now.
Excuse me. That's my brother waiting. Hang your coat and enjoy the party. Also, don't forget to sign the guest book.
As your family attorney, I...
Shut the door, Marvin. This is a private affair.
What kind of party is this? I have my mustache, and I demand more champagne.
Excuse me, Mrs. Greenwald isn't feeling well. Would you please take this tray to her room upstairs while I serve our diva here? Mrs. Greenwald was looking forward to meeting you anyway. Bringing her dinner would make a very good first impression.
You frightened me. I wasn't expecting anyone but Mildred. Who are you? Oh, yes. I saw the moving truck through the window. I wasn't sure you would make it to the party. I'm so glad to be the first to meet our new neighbor. A car accident left me with these terrible headaches that just won't go away. I've had to spend most of my time in this dimmed room ever since. Maybe it's better that way. Don't be fooled by the happy little town charade. Mildred is the only person I trust right now. Even this box hides a truth if you scratch the surface. I'll show you right after I have a bite to eat.
Mrs. Greenwald, what have you done to her? Sheriff!
Dorothy! No!
See if you can find a way into the mansion. That hidden box is our only hope to clear my name. Be careful. And don't trust.
Your spouse's personal effects are on that desk over there. We've already got what we need for the investigation, so feel free to take whatever's left.
The Greenwald family has lived in Hidden Pines for four generations. Long ago, they opened the first fishing equipment store in town. Right after his 25th birthday, William Greenwald took over the store from his father Francis. He grew the business into a respectable empire. As the current mayor of Hidden Pines, William Greenwald promised to restore the old town and turn the original Greenwald store into a museum.
Thank you.
You listen to me, James. You owe me for approving your job application back when you were just a dumb kid. Get out of my way.
I'm sorry, Mayor, but you can't go inside until the forensics crew finishes their job. We're expecting them any minute now.
I'm sorry, officer. He's still in shock. Come on, William. Let's go. They're just doing their job.
Move along, please. Move along, please.
Thank you.
is just an old clock. I guess I'll keep searching.
Stop right there. The Greenwald residence is currently off limits to civilians.
This is all just a misunderstanding. We had been searching for Caesar for the past half hour. But it turns out Caesar was outside all along. Your spouse is innocent. I'm so sorry I've caused trouble for you. I just want to make things right. I found Betty's scarf in the kitchen. She was there with William the whole evening. Maybe she saw something suspicious. She's staying at the hotel on the Market Square. Good luck.
I didn't realize Betty and William had an affair. This complicates things, since arresting Betty would cause a big stir in the town. We'll need concrete evidence before we can do that. Speaking of evidence, I have the new toxicology report. Turns out Dorothy was poisoned using pufferfish toxin. Given this new evidence, I can release your spouse, but you should stay at home. We might need you later.
Caesar, wait! Sorry, I've got to get him.
Moving services. How can I help you? Maple Street? Okay, I'll send someone to move our vehicle at once.
You did it! What would I do without you, hon? The sheriff filled me in. Sounds like Betty knows more than she's saying. I think it'd be best if I talk to her alone. I'll seem less suspicious.
Betty Porter? No, I don't recall that guest's name. Maybe you can jog my memory? I think you've grossly underestimated my power here. Please excuse me for a moment. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
I didn't call for room service. Yes, that is my scarf. I must have dropped it in the kitchen. I was there most of the night talking with William. William and I? I wish. There's never been anything between us. He just told me to stay the hell away from him and let him grieve. Dorothy wasn't the saint everyone thought she was. She had an affair with Dr. Roberts. I followed her to prove that to William, but I suppose that doesn't matter now.
Yes, I'm Dr. Roberts. Have you ever heard about doctor-patient confidentiality? Why should I share my patient's private information with you? I stopped treating her for personal reasons. I entrusted her file to her family lawyer, Mr. Clifford, so he could find a new doctor. The last treatment I recommended was a seafood diet, primarily tilapia in her case. But I don't see how that could matter now that she's dead. Nothing does. Go ahead, conduct whatever you may call your investigation, so I can just get back to work.
Thank you.
Another murder? Don't touch anything. Wait for me in front of the office.
I just saw a man in a hooded black coat leaving the office in a hurry.
Showing up at crime scenes is becoming too coincidental for you, Mrs. Fletcher. You're free to go, but please don't leave town and keep yourself available.
Situation is getting worse and more dangerous for that matter, so I'm not comfortable with you going to the pier. I'll go. I just need my picture from your wallet so I can make a pier pass and go to the docks.
Okay, you should have everything you need. Be careful, Aaron.
Have you seen William? My brother? I've been looking for him all over town. I'm afraid this whole tragedy is taking a toll on his mind. I must find him, so please, excuse me. Thank you.
Members only! Get lost!
I don't have time for chit-chat right now. My ship, the Alex, is getting ready to set sail.
A local smuggler paid me to transport a special cargo from South America. No questions asked. Look, I just needed that job. The smuggler hangs out in the secret gambling room down the pier. Take this. It will lead you to my member pass on the ship.
For special cargo, you'll have to earn that info. Fancy a game of cards.
Thank you.
Let's see how badly you want this information. That was beginner's luck. I'll get you next round. Fair and square. Some lawyer hired me to smuggle a rare fish aboard the Alex. We never met face to face, but we exchanged notes in the library. Here, take this. You'll need it to enter the library.
Yes, I still have that document. It's in the old town office, so let's go there now.
I'm sorry, the library is closed to the general public, unless you have a tourist permit. Your permit seems in order. You can help yourself to any book in here. But if you want to use the planetarium, that'll be $2.
There you are. Oh, I've been looking for you all over town. We've got to head down to the old town, and I need your help. We'll have to turn the two gate keys simultaneously. Here, take this one.
William and Marvin must be around here somewhere.
Thank you.
Greenwald Incorporated was established in 1921. It all started with a small fishing store that grew over time, making the Greenwalds the wealthiest family in Hidden Pines. After Francis died, his sons divided the family fortune. William took over the business side of things, while Marvin used his money to study abroad in Europe and sail around the world. William stayed in Hidden Pines, spending much of his fortune on restoring parts of the old town and converting Francis's store and home into a museum.
We can't cross that mud unless we lower that steel beam using the crane. Get in. I'll guide you. Move the crane to the left. Now to the right. Okay, stop. Now forward, just a bit. Perfect. Now just lower it.
Thank you.
hand. He's tied to the pier. Cold. Can you find something strong to wake him up?
I can't thank you enough for everything you've done. You should know, Marvin is the one who tied me up down here. I thought he was helping me through this whole ordeal, but I was gravely mistaken. There isn't an ounce of humanity left in him. Please, you must stop him.
Let's let him get away. Take this.
So, we finally meet at the end of it all. I pulled you into this with that invitation. You were the perfect scapegoat until you got nosy.
When I asked Will to share the family fortune, do you know what he did? He refused me. His own brother, that ungrateful scoundrel. But now, I've had my revenge. Dorothy is dead, and soon Will shall join her.
The boat won't start. It's out of fuel.
I cannot thank you enough for not only saving my life, but bringing my wife's murderer to justice. You two are Hidden Pines' bravest neighbors. We're lucky to have you.